be like this, but now I'm coming with a new plan. Gonna take a stand, gonna find a way to change the game. You tell me that I should stay, trust what you say and that it's all okay. But everything starts to feel like a con, and I'm the pawn, am I right or wrong?
This week, we're going to head up to the always lethal location of Alberta, Canada, the bow hunting mecca of the world, in my opinion. We're going to be up there with Red Willow Outfitters, and I'm going to be accompanied by my good friend Corey Friesen, who's after his first elk with his bow. Now, if any of you bow hunters haven't experienced Alberta, I guarantee you need to get up there because there's plenty of animals. In the early season, there's lots of velvet, and there's always opportunities.
Initializing connection. Loading contact. Selecting field equipment. Equipment selected. Targeting destination.
Knocks come out, green knocks go in. It's August 25th, we're in Alberta. Let the death begin. Today is the day that the Lord has made for me to go hunting and the elk to get slain. You like that song, Steve?
I do.
It's a good one.
I like the fact that you just made it up too.
Ever see Return of the Jedi? The speeder bike scene through the woods? This was just like that, only really, really slow. The herd was everywhere, and we had the heads-up decoy, which brought us in real tight. Cows to the left, cows in the middle, cows in the right, couldn't see the bull. But this cow gave us a shot, and I got a full freezer. It's awesome, great hunt, really, really good hunt. Red Willow Outfitters, Knock On TV, my cow.
Knock On TV is brought to you by Under Armour, always lethal. Nikon, your trusted name in optics. Lancaster Archery Supply. Fuse Archery Accessories. Sherlock brand hunting sights. And Yamaha ATVs and side-by-sides. Real world tough.
Spider, it's the best bow I've ever taken to the woods.
Short, compact, light, and perfectly balanced.
Talking about a bow that's poison on whitetail.
This is a giant.
Spider, born for one purpose. Get serious, get Hoyt.
Great achievements have a way of creating even greater expectations. Especially when the achievements are greatly unexpected. Like an uncompromisingly rugged hunting binocular built to defy the elements, yet whose high-resolution optics also defy dawn and dusk. The all-new ProStaff 7. Outdoor life's great buy for 2011. It's what you'd expect from Nikon at a value that is unexpected.
Dead center.
On this week's Dead Center, I want to talk about how you can make sure your peep height is always perfect for you. And that's going to be the same measurement all the time, regardless of the size of your bow, if you measure it the correct way. And the reason that there is a difference is because bows that are shorter versus bows that are longer are gonna have a slightly different string angle when the bow is at full draw. At the full draw position, a shorter bow like this will have a much sharper angle. And the reason that's important is because when you pull back and you have a sharper string angle, in order for that peep to be the correct distance between where you anchor and where your eye is, that peep is actually gonna have to be much higher in the string when the bow is at rest on a shorter axle-to-axle bow versus a longer axle-to-axle bow, again, because that string angle is much sharper. Now, if you know your peep measurement and you can remember that number, then if you go into a new store tomorrow and buy a bow that's 3 or 4 inches different axle-to-axle, or if it has a different brace height or whatever the reasoning for that string angle being different, you can make sure that you get your peep in the correct position so that you're comfortable with that bow right away. And how you do that is, if you've got a bow right now and you really like how it feels and you're comfortable with everything on it, you're gonna need to pull that bow back and you're gonna use either a bow square or a tape measure, and you're gonna measure the distance from the center of that arrow shaft straight up on a vertical position to where your peep sight is in your string. And that measurement right there is the critical number. So if you got a bow that's fitting you and you like how it feels, and if you're the kind of guy like me that likes to get a different bow every year or two, you're gonna wanna make sure you know that peep height. Pull back, anchor, look directly through your peep, and have someone measure the distance from the center of the peep sight down to the center of the shaft.
You're a legend in your own mind.
And nobody else's.
Nothing wrong with that. That's what I am. Straight out there. Straight out that point.
Down on the ground, just hold this up. Yeah. couldn't quite see his vitals. The stuff was so high, but that was unbelievable. We came out here, it's mid-morning, driving around, spotted one bull. I didn't know he had the whole harem. And once again, that heads up decoy, we sent our caller right out here in the open, right out in the wheat with that heads up decoy, made a couple calls and the whole harem came by. Got my bull at 30 yards. That's a sweet bull too, isn't it? Got my man Steve behind the camera. Tell you what, Alberta, man, it's still August, and we got cows and bulls coming to the call.
At first, we were skeptics of this heads-up decoy and thought it was definitely going to be a gimmick, but honestly, it became the determining factor to our hunt.
At Cabela's, on your way to your hunt, you're going to stop and buy it. Because you know you got the...
This could be the sting. This could be the magic elixir right here.
Yeah, every guy gets the family credit card for like the first few days of their hunting season. And you got to buy every gimmick you can while you've got your card. Or otherwise, you're not going to get it.
Carbon is dead. Introducing Under Armour Scent Control. Fusion of odor trapping zeolites with antimicrobial silver. It's more powerful and works longer than carbon. 10 times longer. Strike without warning. Under Armour Scent Control. Never detected. Always lethal.
The moment you've waited for all year long takes seconds to play out. For months now, you've been honing your skills and pushing yourself to the limits of perfection. The entire line of Glendale Bucks feature a massive four-sided shooting core that takes thousands of shots for the longest-lasting, most realistic target. So when the months turn to seconds, you can answer the call. Glendale, the biggest and toughest 3D targets in the universe.
Field Recon.
This week's field recon tip is gonna be about something that actually made this elk hunt successful. Now, this bull came right around the edge of this field, and this was a classic setup for elk. But what's really important is that as a hunter, you need to pay attention to what that sun is doing every bit as much as what you do when you pay attention to the wind. Because if that sun is glaring right on you, even if you have cover around you, you still are very shiny, especially your face and your hands. However, even though I'm in cover right here, what I elected to do was I took one more step back here and I'm totally in the shadows, and that bull was able to come right here at 25 yards and he never had any idea I was here. I was able to pull my bow back and come right up, whereas if I would have been even right here in a good area and had the sun on me, been a big difference pulling back with glare all over your equipment. So put that to use. Pay attention to the sun just as much as you pay attention to the wind. I guarantee it'll help you out.
Is that cool?
That was very cool.
This was an awesome, just textbook elk calling episode. I mean, we drove by about probably a mile off and saw this bull feeding out in this beautiful wheat field that we just came through. And the bull, actually, we thought he was by himself. So we set up about 200 yards away, did the ideal thing, put the collar behind us. We actually put the collar out in the field with that decoy. And we set up in front of him and he literally called this big old bull and his whole crew right past us. And hardest part about this whole thing, to be honest with you, was being able to find where to put my arrow, because that crop was about halfway up his body, and I was the only thing I really had to judge my shot placement by was the hump of his back and where the dark hair and the light hair meet. But shot him, and real good testament to a good, nice, sharp broadhead.
Closed captioning provided by Trophy Taker, the maker of the world's best fall-away arrow rest and the Shuttle T-Lock Broadhead. For over 30 years, Lancaster Archery Supply has practiced the values of integrity, caring, and excellence to archery customers. Discover the largest online selection of bows, arrows, and archery accessories at lancasterarchery.com. Call on our archery techsperts for expert advice on all your archery needs. If you want the best service and gear, then visit Lancaster Archery Supply, America's largest archery-only supplier.
Lancaster Archery Supply.
The world can be a tough place. That's why you need a side-by-side that's even tougher. The 2012 Rhino 700 Fi from Yamaha. The toughest, most off-road capable side-by-side out there. Rhino. Real world tough.
If we see one of these bucks and there's a 130, a 140, and a 150, and any of those bucks that come down this line, and they're gonna have the element of surprise waiting for them right there. I got my buddy Steve from Calgary behind the camera, one of my shooting buddies from the Red Deer Mother of All Shoots is where I met him, and it's gonna be a good night, I hope. So stay tuned, let's do it.
After about an hour, sure enough, all the deer that we had seen in this field the night before started to pile into this lush alfalfa one by one. I was getting really excited. Deer started to file past me, and just about the time I was thinking that these bucks would be next in line, everything just started to scatter and run out of the field. At first, I had no idea what had happened, but soon enough, I figured out it was a stupid coyote.
Just whacked that coyote, and if you can believe it, the only buck that I really wanted to shoot actually heard all the noise, and now we see him. It looks like he's working this edge and coming right around. He might be coming in. This could be the stupidest thing I've ever seen in the whitetail woods.
Classic heart shot. I mean, he did the heart kick and everything. I'm actually in camp with a good buddy of mine. This is Corey right here from UA Canada, and we're just doing a fellowship friend hunt up here in Alberta with Red Willow Outfitters. And once again, August 25th is the opener. If you're missing out, then that's your fault. But this is just classic heart shot, major blood trail. White belly. Dude, that's a stud. Look at that thing.
I'm looking at it.
He's better than what we thought he was, Steve.
Pick him up.
Yeah.
Pick him up.
What a stud.
All velvet.
Dude, that is an awesome buck. Right here in Alberta, you can start hunting, like I said, August 25th, August 26th, depending on the year. And this right here is why you come. Velvet whitetails, velvet muleys, elk, black bears. I mean, you name it. This was, looks like I came out, you know, literally right at the back of the lungs. I think I had a low heart shot. But man, what a stud of a buck, huh,
Put
Corey?
Put him down. It's a great buck.
What's really sweet about coming up here with Todd during this time of year is you just have an opportunity at so many different types of species because they're in their summer pattern still. And the one thing about these Alberta deer or Canadian deer in general is they're just so much bigger body-wise than a lot of the deer that we have in the States. So, I mean, when I saw this rack, I was like, well, you know, he's a 125, 130 buck for sure. But, you know, you slap that on a body that's 50 pounds bigger than what we're used to looking at, and that rack just grew like 10 more inches. I mean, this is a heck of a deer. 18 inches wide, palmated, big old, I mean, that would count as a point. A couple of those are an inch anyway. A little mini split G2 right there. Look at him, he's like doing the knock on. Yeah.